there's a lot of discussion now talking about how we rebuild our economy, both nationally and locally. There's a big campaign that started, Save Our Venues, which tries to preserve the music venues that we have, not just in Brighton, but elsewhere as well. How do you think we can make that happen? Not just music venues, but our economy locally. What do you think we need to do going forward?
Now, there's a number of things that we can do. One is that we and others are calling on the government to make sure the furlough schemes and other schemes continue, not until just the end of lockdown, but until places can get their feet back, themselves back on their feet. And that might mean some additional grants and support. We think that some of the small loans should be converted into grants. Rather than putting people in debt, we should be trying to boost them. But locally, we need to start thinking really creatively now.
What would you do in order to revive the tourism and hospitality industries in particular?
Let's assume that it will mean more staycations, we can hope, for the time being. And that might mean places like Brighton become busier. And I think that means that we need to become a city that can accommodate all different kinds of people, not just for the daytime visitors, but visitors for a few nights, family friendly, as well as, of course, the Stag and Hen do.
What about the national picture then? What do you think about the government scheme so far, the furloughing scheme?
I think the furloughing scheme has been very successful. Yeah. And I think the self-employed scheme has been very successful where it has reached the right people. The problem has been that there has been a number of loopholes that the government haven't been willing to accommodate, which I think is a great shame. And I personally think that it would have been easier and quicker for the government to have given a universal credit to everyone of, say, £1,000, £2,000 for the period, and then claimed it back on tax. So those who continued earning would have ended up paying the £2,000 or maybe even a bit more back in tax, because you would have adjusted the tax code.
Yeah.
And those who weren't earning would have then gained it, and it would have reduced the paperwork, it would have got the money out to people quickly. Now, it didn't happen, and so it's a bit late to ask for that now, but I think there is some sort of questions around universal credit, universal basic income going forward, and I think there is some issues around making sure that we get things like universal credit right.
Thanks for talking to us again. All the best in the future. Obviously, we're going to catch up again soon anyway, so thanks.
Cheers. A lot. You too. Cheers. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.